Hi, my name is Dave Fuller. I work with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension as an agriculture and non-timber forest products professional. Today we're going to talk about how to identify and properly or sustainably harvest ostrich fern fiddleheads. Fiddleheads have been enjoyed by many generations of Mainers, beginning with Native Americans, and they're enjoyed by families all over the state where they are found primarily along river and stream beds. Before you begin to think about harvesting though, you really should get the landowner's permission. And if you're not familiar with who the landowner is, you can just stop by the local town office, be able to point out the property on the map, and they can provide you with the owner's name. That's public information. In identifying ostrich fern fiddleheads, we first look for a smooth, dark green stem. The second way is to look at the inside of the stem. It should have a deep U-shaped groove. Other ferns are primarily round. The third way is to look for the papery covering. It's kind of a brown color. This is evident as the ferns, fiddleheads first come out of the ground and then it falls off as they grow. And then the fourth way is from the fertile frond. This is what produces the spores. Not all plants will have this, but it also has a deep U-shaped groove, and overall it kind of resembles a feather. With any natural resource, we always have to have an eye towards sustainability. In the case of harvesting fiddleheads, the research has shown that we need to leave half the fiddleheads in a given crown. So this would be a crown here. We have about 8 fiddleheads. It's best to just snap the fiddleheads off rather than use a knife, because you may cause damage to the rest of the fiddleheads. This clump has 8, so we'll pick 3, for example, out of this clump. A properly harvested fiddlehead, one that's good for home and also for market, should have a tightly coiled head on it with maybe 2, maybe 3 inches of stem, but the frond should not be unfurling yet and there shouldn't be any leaves on the stem itself. So with a better understanding of how to harvest ostrich fern fiddleheads, we should be able to enjoy this spring treat for many generations to come.